This is Joe and Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you coming at you from my beautiful backyard garden. End of December. Hope you guys are having some happy holidays and a happy new year if I don't talk to you between now and then. In any case, in this episode, I want to show you guys the easiest way to plant your companion plants with your greens or your leafy green vegetables, right? This time of year, I'm growing all kinds of leafy greens in my garden, and I plant many different companion plants. Now, I know some gardeners on YouTube aren't a big fan of companion plants, and they think it's hogwash and all this stuff, and all I want to say is that I don't care if you want to call it companion plants or planting plants next to each other, but I just kind of consider it following nature. Nowhere in nature does there only exist only kale plants, you know, but there'll be always grasses and weeds and things mixed into different forests. You know, there's never one kind of species. So, you know, I like to plant some plants with other plants. Whether you want to call it companion planting is up to you. I don't really care the definition or the name you put on it. I care that you guys maximize your food production and go for your goals in life. My goal, actually with my garden anyways, is to grow the highest quality food. And by planting things together, or companion planting, if you will, I can fit in more nutrient-dense foods and grow more so that I could benefit from them. The two companion plants I'll be showing you guys in this episode are the most nutritious leafy green vegetables and foods you guys should be growing and eating on a regular basis. There are multiple studies showing that these plants are actually anti-cancer. Cancer is one of the largest killers in America and around the world today, aside from things like heart disease. Some of these plants also are anti-aging and will provide nutrients such as the sulfur in some of the allium family plants. So I'll be talking about the brassicas and the alliums, but that being said, I plant alliums with basically all my leafy greens in the same bed. While I'm sitting here today, this is a bed that I think I planted probably in maybe September. And this is one of my beds that's currently in production of my kale. I have dinosaur kale, I have burgundy kale, I have my amazing sweet Siberian kale, just standard curly kale. And in this bed, I basically planted these guys about every 9.5 inches apart when they were young transplants. Since then, they've gotten bigger, but I've also dropped in the middle of them. If you guys could see here, on the edge here, I have a garlic here, basically planted right in the middle of every of these plants. I have garlic. Actually, this guy's just shooting out the ground there. But why did I interplant these guys? Well, some people say, oh, you should companion plant for pests. You know, maybe if you plant your garlic here in between, you know, maybe the scent of the garlic will basically deter aphids and white flies from coming. Maybe if you have lots of garlic and onions planted, it'll deter rabbits and or deer from coming in your garden. If you have like one this small, it's probably not gonna do nothing. Rabbits are gonna come anyways. But if you line the outside of this bed with garlic or onions and it has a strong smell, it'll mask the smell of the kale, and the, you know, the other animals will stay away. You know, it was a garden up I went to in Colorado that actually used like cannabis plants around the vegetable garden, which was ingenious because a strong smell of the hemp cannabis there grown, you know, basically deterred insects and animals from eating the vegetables on the inside. Actually, I liked that episode a lot. Link down below to that video if you guys haven't seen it already. Any case, so the reason why I grow these guys, honestly, is just to have more food growing. I'm actually space challenged. I just live in a standard residential tract home lot, and I don't have endless acres to plant things, because surely if I did, I would have, you know, a bed of garlic, and I'd have a bed of kale, and I'd probably just toss in seeds, and I wouldn't pay as much attention to, you know, interplanting or companion planting, if that's what you guys want to call it. In any case, I've come up with some tips and tricks to companion plant, and for those of you guys that don't know about companion planting, I'm going to share with you guys the four easiest ways to companion plant along with your kale, beets, lettuce, or other greens. This bed that you guys can't see right on the other side is actually planted with lettuce, red lettuces, and in between there I have actually shallots planted. Post a link down below to my Instagram where I actually have a picture of interplanting and getting this set up to plant them. Anyways, let's go ahead over to a table first, and we're going to share with you guys actually the easy allium plants that you guys can easily transplant this time of year. And also, I want to share with you guys, after that, we're going to share with you guys how I plant these transplants quick and easeless and effortlessly to the right depth every single time. All right, so now I'm going to show you guys the easy way to companion plant the allium family of plants. You could start from seed, but I'm not a big fan of seeds. They take a lot longer to grow. And so this is how I planted this bed out that you guys just saw with garlic. And this is some garlic I got at a local farm. You know, you don't want to get conventional garlic. It may be sprayed with growth inhibitors and a lot of garlic these days. Conventional is coming from China. Anyways, this is from a local farm. And look, these guys are actually sprouting up. You want to make sure these are undamaged, you know, and try to get the biggest cloves as possible. And more importantly, also try to get the variety of garlic that will grow well in your area, because these are literally from a farm in my same city. I know these are the variety they're going to produce well in my climate zone. So literally, I just planted these guys in between all my brassicas, and now I have the garlic to eat. Now, I know a lot of you guys are thinking, John, your garlics, man, they're being shaded out by the kales, because the kales overtook them, because I planted the garlics, you know, as bulbs, and the plants as the transplants, right? You know, my goal, while it is nice to grow some garlic cloves, actually more nutritious than the garlic cloves to me are the garlic greens. So I'm actually just growing those for the greens. And if they should make the garlic cloves, and the whole heads at the end of the season, hey, great, that's a bonus for me. But I really want the leaves. The leaves are way more nutritious than simply the bulbs that most people eat, okay? Now, the bed behind me that you guys can see in between this bed, I basically dug a hole and I planted shallots. So these shallots are actually just our shallots. They're an allium family plant. They're kind of like similar to an onion. And I just basically went to the organic health food store and I bought these guys. Or when you buy organic, they shouldn't be sprayed with growth inhibitors and all these things, and they should basically just grow. So I went to the store and I just picked out all the ones that were small, because they had a lot of ones that were bigger, but I wanted to get the small ones so I could easily pop them in the ground a lot easier. And so I bought a bunch of these guys to plant in my garden as well, and they were all planted in with my lettuce, and some of these guys are already just starting to break ground and break the surface. Okay, so that's these two, garlic, shallots, and then now today, actually, I was out shopping, and I found these guys. They're on clearance after Christmas for 99 cents, so I'm like, I'll just buy them and plant them. Normally, I would only recommend organic ones. These ones happen to be organic pearl onions by Melissa's. They're products of the USA. And you could also just buy these guys, because literally they are little mini onions that then you will plant. So you always want to plant these the right direction. The right direction is, you know, with the little root end facing down, because this is the end that's going to sprout up. Same with these guys, right? This end goes down, that end goes up, and on the garlics, obviously, the end where it's sprouting is, the part you want going up, and the part that you just disconnected from, like, the little head thing that's holding it all together is at the bottom, that is facing down. So, yeah, this is another thing you could plant, just like pearl onions. I got this from a gardener out in Houston when I visited. And another way, easy way to plant alliums is just basically from, these guys. You know, I bought these at a farm in California. And so you can just get the little onion sets and just, plant these guys. They have roots and all. So, I mean, that's a little bit easier. Just pop these guys in and plant them. They're a little bit easier than digging the little holes for these guys. These are red torpedo onions. I think I also got some sweet Walla Wallas that I'll be planting as well. You want to ensure, if you get the onions, if you want to grow them for the bulbs themselves, you want to make sure you get the right day-length onions for your area. So you want to look it up and get the right ones. Generally, nurseries near you will sell the right ones for your area. If you're growing onions that are not in your specific zone, you may just get the greens, and they're not going to make that nice big onion you're used to. But once again, I'm growing the shallots, the onions, and the garlic for the greens primarily. And should I get onions, garlic, or shallots at the end of the season when it's done, hey, that's a bonus for me, right? My goal is to basically go around and harvest and pick greens and things and eat them, let them grow back and pick more and continue to eat those on a regular basis so I could get those in me all times of the year versus, if you want to grow for the onions, you got to wait till that onion gets big, then you got the onion, then you could eat it fresh, or maybe you could store it for a month or two, or depending on how long you could store it longer, and then you could eat it, right? I want to eat my greens. My channel is called Growing Your Greens, and I want you guys to eat your greens too. Anyways, without further ado, let's go ahead and go to the other side of my garden and show you guys how I'm easily gonna plant any of these, bulbs into my garden. So now we're on the other side of my garden. This is a recently planted out, I think, broccoli bed with English violet and purple sprouting broccoli planted. I think these guys are also about maybe, 9 inches apart or whatever. Now, normal spacing for brassica plants is about a foot apart. I plant them a little bit closer so I could pack more plants in. And my goal is to, harvest them once the leaves are kind of touching each other. I want to plant things in more densely so that I am better and more efficiently able to cover the ground. In addition, I plan on mulching this year after I get my garlic planted. I'm going to go ahead also and mulch over the top to keep the soil microbiome warmer and also help retain water in my arid climate. Anyways, I'm going to show you guys how to plant these little garlic cloves. And what you will need is thin wall PVC pipe, just a random ass size, as well as some other kind of ram rod. I like ramming rods in holes, ramming rods, to clear it out. So what I've done on this PVC pipe, if you guys look, you could see about at 3 inches deep. I actually just have a permanent marker line there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this PVC pipe and basically right in between, in the middle of each plant, and I just eyeball it. I just go in. Let me come back here a little bit. In between each plant, I just come in and I kind of twist and push until I get to the 3-inch mark, right? Then I come up, and if we look in there now, you can't see through there because we got a basically a plug in there. And then I'll come in with my ramrod. It's kind of like you're packing in, a musket ball, and ram out the bottom. We're all locked and unloaded, and now we could go on to the next two, between the next two plants. So what I'm gonna do right now, off camera, is we're just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use my ramrod and pluck out holes between each of these broccoli plants. Alright, so I got all those holes dug, one hole in between each plant. I have about 36 plants in here, so that's probably at least 35 holes. So literally I'll be able to double the amount of items I'm growing. At the same time, potentially also, giving my brassica plant some protection from other insects because of the strong scents. But once again, my goal is for production. Now the other reason why I like to plant these little cloves are because they are cheap. I mean, I got a big bag of these guys for like $4 from a local farm. You could buy garlic for pretty inexpensive. Once again, get it organic, separate them out, and drop these guys in at the 3-inch depth. And basically the next thing, make sure they're the right side up. And then instead of taking out the plug hole material, I have a special bucket here that I basically mixed together a couple different kinds of worm castings, rock dust, biochar, and some compost in here. So I have a really rich planting mix that I then just go ahead and cover the hole up basically with solid worm castings. So I'm plugging each hole with solid worm castings to give the garlic the nutrients and microbes they will need to thrive, all right? So I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and do this off camera. I'm gonna go ahead and pick out the best, largest garlic cloves and drop one in per hole. And I'm like on a production level, so I basically dig all the holes and then I basically drop one garlic in all of them. And then I cover each hole up and then I water it in. Cross your fingers that they sprout. And if they don't, that's all right. This is a very minimal investment and a very minimal investment in time. Now, the other thing I want to mention is, I don't use a little digger. I don't use my hands. I want to do things precisely, right? I want to try to save time. I have many things to do in my life, and I don't want to sit here and dig holes and dig big holes. I mean, one thing is I do a no-till gardening, and I kind of try to take it to the extreme. I try to minimally disturb the soil as much as possible and just stick in a little, PVC tube in just to get a little plug out is the exact size I need pretty much so that I don't have to dig a big hole and disturb fungi and mycorrhiza and bacteria that's in the soil or mess up any kind of earthworms, right? The other thing also, it's fairly quick to just pop holes in. You guys saw in fast speed mode how I was able to pop all the holes in. I'm just going to basically drop these in, drop in my, you know, worm casting mix on top, water it in, and then I'm off to my next task that I got to do for today. And actually, I think this is the first bed on this side, and I have like 20 of these guys that literally I need to interplant, you know, with the allium family of plants. And actually, I like to do this when they're young. And the other thing I want to mention is that, you know, when these plants have competition, so for example, the garlic comes up, and maybe these brassicas will be a little bit larger and shading them out a little bit like they are on the other side of my garden, right? That will encourage the garlic, hey, I'm not getting sun, I better grow faster and larger to get more sun, right? It's kind of like if you have a best friend that like plays baseball or basketball all the time, you know, and you go out playing one-on-one with them on basketball anyways, you know, you're going to get better and improve and so you could beat them, right? But if you don't have a friend to play basketball with, you're never going to practice and you're not going to get as good. So I really like companion planting because I like nature competing against one another. All right. So those are basically all my tips to grow some companion allium family of plants simply and easily and affordably. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. And if you guys did, hey, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also, please be sure to share this video with somebody else that you think it could help. I encourage you guys to always interplant alliums with your leafy greens to maximize your production and create more nutrient-dense, anti-cancer, and anti-aging foods that you guys could eat. After all, that is the reason why I am gardening to have the highest quality food that literally money cannot buy. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new upcoming episodes that come out every 5 to 7 days. You never know where I'll show up or what you'll be learning or what I'll be doing or teaching on my channel. And make sure you click the little bell so you get notified as my new videos come out. I wouldn't want you to miss any of this cool upcoming, actually, you know, game-changing, you know, things I'll be doing on my channel, you know, in the future. And finally, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge over more hours of content than any other gardener YouTube online. You know, over 1,500 videos, but a lot of my videos are a long format to really get into the nitty-gritty and really teach you guys, you know, about how to grow food in the most healthy way possible. So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. Until then, remember, keep on growing.